Welcome to this brief guide on how to use office scripts in Excel. If you find yourself sitting in Excel each day, constantly completing the same repetitive tasks, then the new Automate tab in Excel is here to save the day. Today I'll show you how to utilize this. Here I have a quick table that I've knocked up, showcasing how much of each particular fruit I ate in 2020, as well as how much I ate in 2021. Let's just pretend these numbers are accurate. But what I would like to do with my table is actually color code it and sort it to make it easier to understand. So what I'd like to do is make my lemons a lovely yellow color, maybe my oranges in an orange color and my limes in a lime green color. And I could do this manually, but if this is something that I do pretty regularly, I can actually utilize the Automate tab to set up a script to make this happen. Once I click on the Automate tab, I will have a new section to select from, including some sample scripts. And if I hit the drop down arrow, I'll be able to see all of the sample scripts, plus any ones that I have recently accessed will start to show up there at the top as well. I also have a quick option to access shared scripts should there be some that I have accessed from other users. I also have a quick button that can take me to all scripts, which will bring in the sidebar and show me any recently accessed scripts. At the moment, I don't have any. I also have a tab that will take me to sample scripts. So these are some that Microsoft has already created that can be utilized. If you'd like to make any edits to them, just simply hit the pen icon on the highlighted script. For this demonstration, I've already got a script created, so we're going to go to New Script. And the first thing we'll need to do is name the script so we know what it's meant to be doing. In this particular one, I'm just going to call it Fruit Galore. Now, I'm going to paste in my existing notes here for my script, and we'll just go over what this script does. The first thing it will do is going to select the row 2 and make it a particular color. You'll notice I've used a hex code for this. I'm then going to select the third row and I'm going to make that designated as yellow. You'll notice I've been able to use the name for certain colors as well. For the fourth row, I'm going to make that lime. And then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to select the entire sheet there and I'm going to create a table for the entire data range that I have. And then last but not least, I've asked it to sort my table in descending mode. Now that my script is ready to go, I'm just going to hit save to make sure none of those changes get lost. And then I select the run option and boom, there's my table already color coded and sorted and ready to be used. So as you can see, I've got my oranges and they've all been highlighted in orange. I've got my limes in a lovely lime green and my lemons in yellow. And my table is sorted in descending order, showcasing that I truly love oranges and I'm not a big fan of grapefruits. Now, when I click on the Automate tab, what you'll notice is that that script that I just created is showing up there right at the beginning because it was a recently accessed or created script. What I also have access to on this Automate tab is the Automate a Task option. This will give us a separate sidebar menu where we can choose to create flows utilizing web-based sources such as Office 365 and others. Scrolling through these will give you a selection. Clicking on any of these or even clicking on the More Templates button found here at the bottom will open up your web browser to the Microsoft Power Automate page where you can then look through and set up any of these scripts and even automate them to set off repetitive tasks. And that is how you use Office scripts in Excel. I really hope you get to utilize this feature and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.